गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास। दिस इज द फर्स्ट वीडियो सेशन। द टाइटल ऑफ द वीडियो सेशन इज कंप्यूटर ग्राफिक्स एंड मल्टीमीडिया फॉर फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर आईटी डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट्स। बिफोर गोइंग टू द टॉपिक, फर्स्ट वी नो द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द कोर्स। इन दिस कोर्स we will learn about the basic use of graphics, understand the use of graphics in different application area, know about how to view and modify the image in 2D and 3D format, and also learn the different image file format and understand the different audio and video file format. So students, in this class we will discuss about what is computer graphics, why we use computer graphics or importance of computer graphics, elements of computer graphics, advantages of computer graphics. After this class you will have to overall idea about computer graphics. So first we discuss concept of computer graphics. Computer graphics is the branch of computer science that deals with generating images with the aid of computers or different tools of computers. Computer graphics is also responsible for displaying art and image data effectively and meaningfully to the consumer or meaningfully to the user. It is concerned with all the aspects of producing image using a computer. It concerned with the pictorial synthesis of the image or of the rendering graphics or image. So in this session, computer graphics is also a computer science and art. When we combine computer science and art or drawing, combine each other, it form as a computer graphics using different tools and algorithms or different programmings, etc. Next, come to the definition of computer graphics. Computer graphics is an art of drawing pictures on a computer screen with the help of programming. In other words, we can say that computer graphics is rendering tool for the generation and manipulation of images. It involves display, manipulation, storage of picture and experimental data for proper visualization using a computer. It also involves computation, creation and manipulation of large volume of data. It provides methods for producing images and animations in a sequence. It deals with the hardware as well as different software support for generating the images. Next, now we discuss about the elements of graphics. The elements of graphics are five elements. First one is imaging, modeling, rendering, animation and setting. Next, discuss the first point, imaging. Imaging means simple still picture or digital image. Okay. Computer imaging is a wide field that includes digital photography, scanning, composition and manipulation of bitmap graphics or still photograph. Okay, next come to the point or topic, modeling. Modeling means what? Modeling describes the shape of the object. It also refers to the representation of 3D images. Next come to that point, rendering. Rendering or image synthesis is the process of generating a photorealistic or non-photorealistic image from 2D or 3D model by means of computer program or by using computer program. Rendering also converts a model into an image either by simulating light transport basis. The rendering means in this picture you will show, in this picture it will show, first we draw a circle, then we color this circle, then we shading different types of effect. This is the process, is in this process first the circle convert to an for realistic image. This process is called rendering. Next come to the point, animation. Animation refers to the simulation of sequence of images over time. It also describes the motion of an object. It refers to the temporal description of an object, how it moves over time, or how its different effects are. Animation also have different types of animation. Keyframe animation, motion viewing animation, so different types of animation. The different types of animation are, we'll cover in the practical classes. Okay. Next come to the point, shading. Shading is also called texturing. It is the process of describing surface appearance of the object. Shading also different types of shading. In this figure, first picture is the no shading. That means none. The shading can be three types: flat shading, gaud shading, and pong shading. Okay. Next, computer. Why we use computer graphics or importance of computer graphics? Interactive computer graphics allows the physician or allows the user to interact this large volume of data in new and useful ways. That means, large volume of data we can remember or learn or understand is very difficult. But the large volume of data is represented in a graphical way, it is easily understandable. The computer graphics has also expanded the boundaries of art and entertainment. The development of computer graphics has made possible virtual reality or a synthetic reality that exists only inside a computer or using the computer. For example, the movies like Jurassic Park, the extensive use of computer graphics or more use of computers or imagination or animations. Or another example is flight simulators. When we trained a pilot to give a plane or in these things, it is huge amount of cost, will be very expensive. When we train a pilot using the computer graphics, it is very easy. And computer graphics is also used in surgical or surgical simulators or medical facilities. When surgeons are trained using surgeons are trained using the computer graphics to how to operate the patient, how to operate the patient in this way without endangering the patient. So this is the importance of or examples of some examples of computer graphics. Next come to the advantages of computer graphics. Advantages, first one is usability. Computer graphics or graphical technique offer more flexible and options compared to other traditional methods in designing. Second one is research and development products. Graphical representation software contribute much in research. Models can be presented in 3-dimension, 2-dimension ways, and giving researchers a broader picture of how natural phenomena operate. In engineering, presentation of model in 3D manners enables engineer to identify the weakness in structure and areas of possible improvement. And third one is time. Computer aided design or CAD, on the other hand, involves designing of a graphical presentation in a virtual model. Tests are then done on the model using special software. This saves not only the time but also the resources. Okay, then last one is designing. Advertising is an important aspect in the business world. Customers respond to product or services depending on how it represented to them. Okay, these are the advantages of computer graphics. Next, come to the point. Last one, disadvantages of computer graphics. First disadvantage is complexity. Second disadvantage is limitations. The complexity means what? A majority of complex graphical system applications require prior training before use. Before using any application, we can train them. Some of the graphical applications are so complex that they need an expert to install and customize the setting. Without expert, we can install or we can use the graphics software or different graphics applications. Last one is limitations. Like all other computerized systems, graphical systems has lacked the intelligence of understanding the real world condition and principles like the purpose of the structure it is designing. So students, that's all in the class, and I hope you all have understand our overall idea of the computer graphics, what is computer graphics, or elements of computer graphics, why we use computer graphics, or advantages and disadvantages. So that's all. Next topic we will discuss in next class.